Good morning to everyone. I am Gaurav Gupta. This is our next lecture on class 11, chapter 5, exercise 5.2. In our first two lectures, we already solved the question number 1 to question number 10. Now we have to take it our next question and we have to solve one by one. So in this lecture, what we are going to solve, we have to take three topics. First one topic is additive inverse. Second topic is multiplicative inverse. And third one topic is square root of a complex number. So in this we are going to take one by one each topic. These topics are very, very important. And also we try to do some tricks to solve such type of question very quickly. So before to start the video, I request to everyone, please listen to me carefully and watch the video from start to end. So our first topic is additive inverse. What is additive inverse? Additive inverse is basically what, let I have two is our number, and what is its additive inverse? We already discussed such type of concept in class 8. What's the additive inverse? It means we have to add in this number so that it becomes 0. So then what will be the additive inverse of this? Is negative 2. If we add 2 with minus 2, the result will be 0. This is called the additive inverse. So in this we have a not a number, but we have a complex number. Suppose this is our complex number, and complex number is basically represented by capital letter Z. So Z denotes the complex number. So what is the additive inverse? Is similar to negative Z, because if we add them we get a result 0. But in this case 0 is not a number, it indicates your complex number. So you can write it as 0 plus 0 iota. So this one becomes your additive inverse. I hope you will understand this concept. Now this concept we have to apply it on our all the questions. Our question number 10, find the additive inverse of the following parts. Our first part is minus 3 plus 4 iota, and we know this is our complex number Z, and we know what's additive inverse of Z is negative Z. Additive inverse of a complex number is negative Z. So our answer is what? Negative of Z. Z is what? This is your minus 3 plus 4 iota. If we solve them, what we will get? Negative negative becomes positive 3 minus 4 iota. This one is your final answer. So it's very easy. Now what you have to keep it in your minds, you have to solve first. If the complex number is not in the form of a plus iota b, you have to make it in forms of a plus iota b, then you have to multiply it with minus 1, you get the additive inverse. In this question, minus 3 plus 4 iota is already in the form of a plus iota b, because real part is minus 3 and imaginary part is 4. So it is in the form of a plus iota b. But please look up next part, 3 plus 5 iota whole square. It's not a part in terms of a plus iota b, because in this we are get a whole square. So we have to express it first in the form of a plus iota b. Now do express in the terms of a plus iota b. What we have to do? We have to do just solve the identity a plus b whole square. So what's the result? A square plus b square plus 2ab. 2 into 3, 6 into 5, 30. It means 30 iota. Now solve this. 3 plus square is 9. 25 iota square is negative 1 is equal to 30 iota. So it becomes 9 minus 25 plus 30 iota. So 9 minus 25, which is equal to minus 16 plus 30 iota. Now what will be the additive inverse? So additive inverse is because this is in the form of a plus iota b. We have to do multiply minus 1, 16 plus 30 iota. We get an answer is minus 16 minus 30. Here we have already negative, so it becomes positive 16 minus 30 iota. This is your answer. 16 minus 30 iota. This one is your final answer. So keep it in mind, what is your additive inverse is basically, if a plus iota b is your complex number, then what will be its additive inverse is minus a minus iota b. This one is your final answer. Now look at this part. We have to do its additive inverse. Firstly, we have to do write in the form of a plus iota b, but in here I'm gets a imaginary number. In this term I'm also get a imaginary number, so we have to solve it first. And we know negative is replaced by iota square, so we can negative sign is replaced by iota square. We get 5 iota. 9, if we solve this iota, square root of 9 is 3, iota square is iota with plus iota. Now solve this, we get 3 iota square plus 5 iota. Now solve this, iota square is negative 1, so we get minus 3 into minus 1 plus 5 iota. So minus 3 plus 5 iota, this is in the form of a plus iota b. Now what will be the additive inverse? So answer, additive inverse of minus 3 plus 5 iota is what? Negative. We have to do multiply with negative. It becomes negative negative positive minus 3 minus 5 iota. This one is your final answer. So I hope you understand this concept. It's very very easy. But you have to do just express in the form of a plus b iota b. Then second step is to multiply it with minus 1, you get the desired additive inverse. Please make a note. So this is our fourth part of the question number 10. We have to find out the additive inverse. I hope you understand the concept of how to calculate the additive inverse. Additive inverse can be solved in two steps. First step is to express the complex number in terms of a plus iota b. It means you have to separate real part and imaginary part. Then you have to do multiply it with minus 1. That will be the desired additive inverse of any complex number. So look at these examples, questions. 3 minus negative square root of 16. It means firstly we have to express in the terms of a plus iota b. And we know negative sign is replaced by iota square. So what's the result? 3 minus 16 iota square divided by 2 minus 9 iota square. So we get 3 minus 4 iota divided by 2 minus 3 iota. But in the denominator terms we get a complex number. So how we do solve? We have to take its rationalization. So by changing the sign of the denominator, we have to do multiply as well as divide. So in this we have multiply 2 plus 3 iota and divide 2 plus 3 iota. Now solve this, 2 into 3 is 6, 2 into 4 minus 8 iota, 3 iota into 3, 9 iota, 3 iota into 4 minus 12 iota square divided by a minus b, a plus b, again a square minus b square. Identity we have to use, 2 square minus 3 square is 9 iota square. Now solve this, 6 minus 8 plus 9 we get plus iota, minus 12 iota square is again negative 1. So 2 square is 4 minus 9 iota square is negative 1. So what will be the result? 6 plus iota minus 12 into minus 1 we get plus 12 divided by 4 plus 9. Now 6 plus 12 which is equal to 18 plus iota, 9 plus 4 is equal to 13. Now solve this. We have to take it form of a plus iota b. So we have to do separate. 18 divided by 13 plus mean iota divided by 13, which is in terms of a plus iota b. Now what will be the additive inverse? So answer is additive inverse of 18 by 13 plus iota by 13 is, we have to multiply with minus 1. If we do multiply with minus 1, we get minus 18 divided by 13 minus iota divided by 3. This one is your final answer. Please make a note. Now our question number 11, we have to find out the multiplicative inverse. And you know what a multiplicative inverse means? We have to multiply a number with a desired number so that the desired result gives us 1, which is called the multiplicative inverse. For example, if I'm taking 2 by 3, this is our number, and we have to do multiply it with any number so that the desired result gives us 1. So it's basically, if we multiply it with inverse means if we multiply 2 by 3 negative 1 and solve this, we get result 1. How it is? Because the power is negative, so we have to change the sign by changing the numerator to denominator and makes denominator to numerator. So what's the result? 2 by 3, which is equal to 3 by 2. Its power becomes 1, and we know if the number has a power 1, it means it doesn't affect the result. So we can easily remove. Now 2 is cancelled out with 2, 3 is cancelled out with 3. We get 1. So this is what? This is our multiplicative inverse. Same we have to do here. But we know multiplicative inverse of a complex number Z is what? Z inverse. Because if we multiply it with, we get a desired result 1. So the multiplicative inverse of Z is Z inverse. It means Z inverse means what? 1 upon me Z is called. Or multiplicative inverse is 1 upon me Z. So please make a note first, then we do solve and keep it in mind such an example, so that you every time you get the meaning of the multiplicative inverse. Please make a note. I hope you're understanding this concept. Now we have to apply this concept on our complex number. Is what our? This is our complex number. So multiplicative inverse of 3 plus 2 iota is what? 1 upon me 3 plus 2 iota. It's very simple. What you have to do? You have to do reciprocal. If you have a complex number and you want to calculate its multiplicative inverse, then you have to do simply reciprocal of that complex number. And after solve that, this one that will be the desired results. So in this, our complex number is 3 plus iota 2 iota. So I am going to take its reciprocal. What's the reciprocal is 3 plus 2 iota. This one is our answer. But the answer cannot be right in terms of the denominator of a complex number. So we have to remove the complex number in the denominator. So what we have to do? We have to do the rationalization, because every time we have to do rationalization. So rationalization in complex number is common steps. Now solve this. 1 upon me 3 plus 2 iota, because this is our answer, but we cannot write in terms of this. So we have to solve this. 3 minus 2 iota divided by 3 minus 2 iota. Now solve this. If you multiply it with 1, we get 3 minus 2 iota divided by a plus b, a minus b, again a square minus b square. So please write a square minus 2 square is 4 into iota square. What will be the result? 3 minus 2 iota divided by 3 square is 9, and 4 iota square is again negative 1. So we get 3 minus 2 iota divided by 9. Minus minus becomes plus, we get plus 4. So it becomes 3 minus 2 iota divided by 9 plus 4, which is equal to 13. Now solve, write in terms of a plus iota b. 3 by 13 minus 2 by 13 iota, this is your final answer. I hope you understand this concept. Now look at the second part, 2 minus 3 iota. It's very simple, it's same as first, so do it yourself. I'm going to take next question, part 3rd, root 6 plus root 7 iota. We have to do the same step. So multiplicative inverse is what? We have to do it reciprocal. So I'm going to take it reciprocal. Root 6 plus root 7 iota. But this is not the final representation of your answer, because the term complex number present in the denominator, we have to do rationalizing. So root 6 minus root 7 iota, root 6 minus root 7 iota. If we multiply it with 1, we get root 6 minus root 7 iota, and again this a plus b, a minus b. So we have to do square of root 6 minus square root of 7 iota. Now what will be the result? Root 6 minus root 7 iota divided by roots, square of root 6 is 6, and this one is 7 iota square. Now further solve, root 6 minus root 7 iota divided by 6 minus 7, and what will be the value of iota square is negative 1. So we get negative 1. Root 6 minus root 7 iota divided by 6, negative negative becomes positive 1 plus 7. Root 6 minus root 7 iota, 6 plus 7, 13. So write in terms of root 6 divided by 13 minus root 7 by 13 iota. This one is your final answer. I hope you understand this question, because this is very very simple. Please make a note. Now I'm going to take next question, question number 5th part, 6 plus 5 iota whole square. It is similar to as next part, 6th part, 2 plus root 3 iota. So do it yourself. I'm take this example because it's very similar. What we have to do? Firstly, we have to do its reciprocal. Before to do apply the concept of multiplicative inverse, we have to try to it solve and make it as simply as simplest form. So I'm going to take make as a simplest form. It is similar to a plus b whole square identity. Now apply on this a square plus b square plus 2ab, 2 into 2 into root 3 iota. We get square of 2 is 4 plus 3 iota square plus 2 into 2, 4 square root of 3 iota. Now if we solve 4 plus 3, iota square is negative 1, so I am putting here negative 1 plus 4 square root of 3 iota. Now solve this, 4 minus 3 plus 4 square root of 3 iota. 4 minus 3, 1 plus 4 square root of 3 iota. Now applying, because first we have to try to solve and make it simplest form. Then apply the concept of multiplicative inverse, because it becomes very easy to solve and find out the multiplicative inverse in this method. Now, multiplicative inverse is what we have to do, just reciprocal. So we get 1 upon me 1 plus 4 square root of 3 iota, but the desired answer cannot be written in terms of denominator having a imaginary or a complex number. We have to do rationalize 1 upon me 1 plus 4 square root of 3 iota multiply 1 minus 4 square root of 3 iota, 1 minus 4 square root of 3 iota. Now to multiply, if we multiply it with 1, we get the same result, 1 minus 4 root square root 3 iota. This is again a plus b, a minus b. So this is 1 square minus 4 root 3 square and iota square as it is. So what's the result? 1 minus 4 square root 3 iota. 1 square is 1 minus 4 square is 16 and root 3 square is 3. 16 into 3, 48. And iota square is negative 1. So we get 1 minus 4 square root of 3 iota divided by 1, negative becomes positive, 48. So it becomes 1 minus 4 square root of 3 iota divided by 49. And it can also be written as 1 by 49 minus 4 upon me 4 square root of 3 divided by 49 iota. This one is your final answer. Please make a note. So we have to do our next question. Question number 11 part is 7th part. Z is 3 plus 4 iota and 4 minus 5 iota. Please keep it in mind, because if we solve this, we get a complex number in terms of numerator, and we have to find out its multiplicative inverse. Then what we have to do? We have to take again the inverse. So again we get a complex number in the denominator. So it's very easy to take, apply first the inverse. We have to do its inverse. So apply multiplicative inverse. What's the multiplicative inverse of it? It's a reciprocal. If we do reciprocal, it means numerator becomes denominator and denominator becomes numerator, because if we have to write 1 upon me, so that terms will be changed. So multiplicative inverse is what? 4 minus 5 iota divided by 3 plus 4 iota. This is the multiplicative inverse of 3 plus 4 iota divided by 4 minus 5 iota. If you find such type of question in terms of numerator and denominator, then it's very easy to apply first multiplicative inverse, without rather to solve in simplest, to make simplest form. You have to first apply its multiplicative inverse by changing numerator to denominator and denominator to numerator. Now solve this. What we have to do? We have to do rationalization. 3 plus 4 iota. Now 3 minus 4 iota divided by 3 minus 4 iota. Now solve this. Multiply it. 3 into 4, 12. Minus 5, 15 iota. Now 4 iota into 4, 16 iota. Plus 20 iota square. Divide by a plus b, a minus b. Again a square minus b square. We got 3 square minus 4 square and iota square. What's the result? 12 minus 15 and minus 16. We got 31 iota. We got 31 iota. Now plus 20 and iota square is again negative 1. We got square of 3 is 9, square of 16 and iota square is negative 1. Solve this. 12 minus 31 iota and this becomes minus 20. So we get 9 and minus minus becomes positive 16. So we got an answer. 12 minus 20, we got minus 8, minus 31 iota divided by 25. So it can be written as minus 8 upon me 25 minus 31 upon me 25 iota. This one is the final answer. It's very, very simple. Now look at the next part, eighth part of the complex number. In this we have to do first simplify, because it's very complex to make it as simple. Now solve this first iota terms as it is. I am going to take multiplication of these two numbers. What's the result we will got? 2 into 3, 6. 2 into 2, 4 iota. 3 into 3, 9 iota. And 3 into 2, 6 iota square. This becomes 5 plus iota. Now solve further. Iota 6. 4 plus 9, which is equal to 13 iota, plus 16, and iota square becomes negative 1. 5 plus iota. Now solve this. Iota 6 plus 13 iota and becomes negative 16 divided by 5 plus iota. Now solve this. Iota 6 minus 16, we got minus 10, plus 13 iota divided by 5 plus iota. Now to multiply, minus 10 into iota, we got minus 10 iota, plus 13 iota square divided by 5 plus iota. Now if we solve this, what we will got? Minus 10 iota plus 13, and iota square is negative 1 divided by 5 plus iota, which is equal to minus 10 iota minus 13 divided by 5 plus iota. Now what we have to do? It's reciprocal. So firstly you have to keep it in mind, and please make a note, then we do solve further. Please do correction what we have to do wrong. In this we write here 6, but in this we write 16. So what's the value is here? 6. So if we get here 6, 6 minus 6 becomes 0. So this results becomes 6 minus 6 is equal to 0. We got iota into 13 iota divided by 5 plus iota. Now solve this. Iota into, which is equal to 13 iota square divided by 5 plus iota, which is equal to 13 iota square is negative 1 divided by 5 plus iota. It means we got minus 13 upon me 5 plus iota. Now we have to find multiplicative inverse. So multiplicative inverse is, the term will be changed, denominator becomes numerator and numerator becomes denominator. Now look at the question, because in the denominator we get a number and the number may be possible, so this is our desired answer. And you can write in terms of desired form, 5 upon minus 13 plus me iota upon me minus 13, and this can be easily written as minus 5 upon me 13 minus iota upon me 13. This is very very simple, so please make a note first. Our next question, question number 12, is what? If a is 3 plus 2 iota, b is 3 minus 2 iota, then we have to prove. What we have to prove? A square plus ab plus b square is equal to 23. It's very easy, because we know the values of a and b, and we have to put it in our left hand side and solve it and get the desired result, which is equal to your right hand side. So please do. I'm going to take left hand side, which is equal to a square plus ab plus b square. Now put the values of a is here 3 plus 2 iota whole square plus a 3 plus 2 iota plus b is what? 3 minus 2 iota plus b square is what? 3 minus 2 iota whole square. Now we have to do so. A plus b whole square, a square plus b square plus 2ab, 2ab. Same here we have to do multiply. This is, please make a note, a plus b, a minus b. So we have to write a square minus b square. So it can be write as 3 square minus 2 iota square. Again, we applying a minus b whole square is what? A square plus b square minus 2 into a into b. Now, this mega note here, this term is positive and this term is negative. So, this cancel out with this term. Here plus 2 iota square, this one is negative 2 iota square. So, this is also cancel out. Now, solve this. 3 square is 9 plus 3 square is 9 plus 3 square is 9. And please solve this. What's the value of this? 2 square is 4 iota square. 9 plus 9 plus 9, which is equal to 27 plus 4. And iota square is negative 1. So solve this. 27, 4 into minus 1, 4, which is equal to 23. And this is our right hand side. So it's very, very easy. Please make a note. So this one is your question number 13. Prove that this is equal to x4 plus 4. It's very easy. Please make a note. You have to take two terms and combine them. You have to solve very easily. How it is? Because look at these terms. This is x plus 1. Again x plus 1. This is iota and this is minus iota. It means it's like a form a plus b and it is like a form a minus b. Again look at this form. This is again x minus 1, x minus 1. So it becomes a and this is b and this is minus b. So it's very, very easy because a plus b, a minus b. It becomes a square minus b square. Again here, a plus b, a minus b. Again it becomes a square minus b square. Now solve it. What is our a? A is what? X plus 1 whole square. And what is b? Iota square. Same here. What is a is? X minus 1 whole square. And what is b is? Iota. Now solve this. X plus 1 whole square. And this becomes iota square is negative 1. Same here, x minus 1 whole square. And iota square becomes negative 1. Now solve this. We can solve this by a plus b whole square. If we solve a square plus b square plus 2ab. And minus minus becomes plus 1. Same here, a square plus b square minus 2ab. And negative negative becomes positive 1. Now solve this. X square plus 2x. And 1 plus 1 which is equal to 2. Same here, x square, 1 minus 2x, and this is 1 plus 1 which is again 2. Now you have to solve it. Now please do multiply. X square, if you do multiply, x square with x square we got x4. X square into 2 we got 2x cube. X square into 2 we got 2x square. Now multiply minus 2x with x square. Minus 2x cube, minus 2x with 2x, minus 4x square, minus 2x with 2, minus 4x. Now you have to do multiply 2 by this number. 2 into x square, 2x square, 2 into 2x which is 4x, 2 into 2 plus 4. Now please solve it. Here the highest power of x5 is no one, another term, so we get x4. Now look at x cube. 2x cube positive and this is negative. Cancel out. Now look at 2x square. This is 2x square plus 2x square, 4x square minus 4x square. It means they are also cancel out. Now look at this. Minus 4x, this is plus 4x. This one is also cancel out. So we get plus 4. And this is our right hand side. We have to prove. It's very, very simple. So please make a note. Now please look at our next question, question number 14. It's very easy and such type of question is very important because every examiner have a question in his mind to put up a question like to prove question in the terms of complex number. But the statement state, please make a look. In this we have given if this term is equal to this term and you have to prove that this x square plus y square is equal to a square plus b square divided by c square plus d square. Now what you have to prove? This. And how we will prove? It's very easy. Firstly, you have to calculate the values of x and y, then put it on the left hand side, then you will got the desired answer. It's very very easy. Please make a look. In this we have given equal, so we have to do equating. But in this term, this is not a plus iota b form, so we have to make first in terms of a plus iota b. What we have to do? We have to do first rationalization to make it in terms of a plus iota b. So please do a plus iota b divided by c plus iota d. I am going to rationalize c minus iota d divided by c minus iota d. Now you have to do multiply. To multiply, c into a, we got ac minus plus bc into iota. Now multiply ad into iota. Now bd into iota square. Now divide. This is a plus b and a minus b. What's the form? A square minus b square. Now apply a square minus b square. Now solve this. AC plus BC iota minus AD iota. Now BD. And what's the values of iota square is? Negative 1. So we have to put, this becomes C square minus iota square D square. Now separate real part and as well as imaginary part. What's the real part is? AC. And this becomes, if we solve this, AC plus BC iota minus AD iota, and negative negative becomes positive BD. Divide by AC square, and iota square is negative 1, and again negative, we have positive C square plus D square. Now we have to separate real. AC plus BD is your real part, so I am taking combined form. AC plus BD is real part, and in these two terms I am going to take iota as a common. If we take iota as a common, we got BC minus AD divided by C square plus D square. Now we have to do separate, divide by real parts as well as imaginary parts. What's the result we got? I am writing here AC plus BD divided by C square plus D square. Same here, plus iota BC minus AD divided by C square plus D square. Now this term is equal to what? X plus iota y. So this is equal to X plus iota y. So now to compare real parts with real parts and imaginary parts with imaginary parts. Here the real part is x, so we get x is equal to what? Real part is this AC plus BD divided by C square plus D square. Now what's the y is the imaginary part, and in this imaginary part is this BC minus AD divided by C square plus B square. So we get the values of x and y. Now we have to put it on this side and we have to prove the right hand side. Now what our left hand side is? Left hand side is our what? X square plus y square. Now put the values. X is what? AC plus BD divided by C square plus B square whole square plus y square. And what's the value of y is? BC minus AD divided by C square plus D square. Now we have to solve this. Please make a note. After that I will have this portion and to solve further part. Now solve next part. I am taking separate power of numerator as well as denominator. So I get AC plus BD whole square divided by C square plus डी स्क्वेयर होल स्क्वेयर. सेम हियर बी सी माइनस ए डी होल स्क्वेयर डिवाइड बाई सी स्क्वेयर प्लस डी स्क्वेयर होल स्क्वेयर. नाउ व्हाट्स द एलसीएम ऑफ दिस? वी गॉट सी स्क्वेयर प्लस डी स्क्वेयर होल स्क्वेयर. नाउ सॉल्व दिस. व्हाट वी विल गॉट? ए सी प्लस बी डी होल स्क्वेयर प्लस बी सी माइनस ए डी होल स्क्वेयर. नाउ आई एम सॉल्विंग हियर. अप्लाई ए प्लस बी होल स्क्वेयर. इफ यू सॉल्व दिस व्हाट विल द रिजल्ट्स? ए स्क्वेयर सी स्क्वेयर. आई एम अप्लाइंग द कंप्लीट, प्लीज मेक अ नोट हियर. ए स्क्वेयर प्लस बी स्क्वेयर प्लस टू ए बी टू ए बी. सेम हियर प्लस ए माइनस बी होल स्क्वेयर. ए स्क्वेयर प्लस बी स्क्वेयर माइनस टू ए बी टू ए बी डिवाइड बाई सी स्क्वेयर प्लस डी स्क्वेयर होल स्क्वेयर. आई एम राइटिंग दिस टर्म इनटू द दिस टर्म. नाउ सॉल्व दिस. व्हाट इज दिस? इट बिकम्स ए स्क्वेयर सी स्क्वेयर. दिस बिकम्स बी स्क्वेयर डी स्क्वेयर. This becomes 2ABCD because ABCD all terms are multiplied. Same here, B square. Same here plus B square C square plus A square D square minus same here 2ABCD again ABCD. So we cancel out this because the terms are same and sign are opposites. But we will put c square plus d square all square. Now write these terms. Remaining terms a square c square plus b square d square plus d square c square plus a square d square. Now divide by this c square plus d square whole square. Now in please how what we have to prove? We have to prove this term, and in this the denominator part should not be come in square form, but in this we got a square form. So it means we have to take common c square plus d square in the numerator so that will cancel out and we get only one power. So we have to make a pair of c square plus d square. We have to take common. I am taking common here a square c square and b square c square. What's the common? Is c square. So I am gets common c square from here a square. Sorry, no, we have to take c square plus d square. What we have to take common in this? A square c square and a square d square. If we take common a square, what we will got? Here we got c square and here we got d square. Same here, if we take b square common, we got d square plus c square, or you can write as c square plus d square divided by c square plus d square whole square. Now take it common c square plus d square. C square plus d square, if we take common, we got a square plus b square divided by c square plus d square whole square. Now the whole square power is come cut with this term, and we got what we got? We got a square plus b square divided by c square plus d square, which is equal to our right hand side. So please keep it in mind. We have to make it c square plus d square. That's why I am taking here a square c square and a square d square. I am taking common a square. So we got c square plus d square. In this we get common b square. So we get c square plus d square. So again we got common c square plus d square. Now we come one power will be cancelled out, and the remaining power we will got. This is our desired answer. Please make a note. Now I am going to take similar question. Question number is 15 is similar to as question number 14. We have to given this terms and we have to prove this. How we calculate? Firstly we have to calculate the values of x and y, then we have to put and get the desired answer. how we solve this? We get equal in symbol, so we have to do equating. So that's why we have to make this sum in terms of a plus iota of b. For this we have to do rationalization. So please do rationalize. X plus iota y is equal to a plus iota b divided by a minus iota b. Now what we have to do? We have to do change the sign of this term and multiply and divide. What we will got? This becomes a into a, which is a square. A into iota b, we got a b iota. Now iota b into a b iota. Now iota b, we got b square iota square. So in this a minus b and a plus b, again a square minus b square. So we will get a square plus ab iota, and ab iota we got 2ab iota. Now b square and iota square becomes negative 1. We got here a square, iota square is negative 1. So we will get a square plus 2ab iota minus b square divided by a square, negative negative becomes positive b square. So we have to take real part. This one is a square minus b square is your real part. A square minus b square real part. And what's the imaginary part is here? 2ab iota divided by a square plus b square. We have to do separate. So divide by each individual. Real part divided by denominator. Same for imaginary. 2ab divided by a square plus b square. This one is equal to x plus iota y. Now we have to do separate. What's the values of real part is? Equating real with real and imaginary with imaginary. Here real part is x and real part is this. It means we have a x value is equal to a square minus b square divided by a square plus b square. And what's the value of y is imaginary part is y. And here the measuring part is 2ab. So we got 2ab a square minus b square. We get the values of x and y. So put it in the equations where we have to prove. Left hand side is what? X square plus y square. Now put what is values of x is? A square minus b square divided by a square plus b square all square plus what's the value of y is here? 2ab divided by a square minus b square all square. Do separate power numerator as well as denominator. What will be the results? A square minus b square all square divided by a square plus b square all square. Same here, 2ab all square divided by a square minus b square. Now we have to solve it. Now please, what's the LCM of these terms? A square plus b square into a square minus b square. Now solve this. A square minus b square. Sorry, we are right wrong here. In this we have positive signs, so we get positive. So what we got? A square plus b square all square. Now this term will be, because I am taking this LCM, and a square minus b square whole square plus, if we solve this whole square, 4 a square b square. Now solve further, apply a minus b whole square. What's the result? A square plus b square minus 2ab. I am applying a minus b whole square identity. Now this one is 4 a square b square divided by a square plus b square whole square. Now if we solve, this is minus 2ab square, this is plus 4ab square. We got plus 2ab square. So here we got a4 plus b4 plus 2a square b square divided by this term as this. Because minus 2 plus 4, we get plus 2. And this is what? This is nothing. This is basically a square plus b square whole square. So please make a note first, then I will write here. Now I am solving here. This is what? A4 plus b4 plus 2k square b square. If I am solve this a square plus b square whole square, what I tell them? I get a4 plus b4 plus 2a square b square. It means this term will be cancelled and we get 1. This is our right hand side. I hope you understand this. Please make a note. Now I am going to solve next question. Question number is 16. This is given and we have to prove this. The steps is same. What we have to do? Firstly, we have to calculate the values of x and y, or you can say that a and b, and put on the left hand side or right hand side and get the corresponding other sides. So in this we have known this is cube root. 1 by 3 indicate cube root, and cube root is eliminated by taking cube on the both sides. So now I am going to take cube on both sides. Taking cube on both sides. So x plus iota y whole power 1 by 3, and I am taking cube. So here a plus iota b whole cube. So this power will be cancelled out. So what we will put? X plus iota y, because power is multiplied with power. So 1 by 3 multiplied with 3, 3 will cancel out, we get only 1. That's why I am right here. Now this is a plus iota b whole cube, and we know in what's the full form of identity, a plus b whole cube, which is equal to a cube plus b cube plus 3ab into a plus b. Now solve this. X plus iota y is this, and we have to solve this. A cube, it becomes iota cube, b cube plus 3ab iota. If we multiply it with a, what's the result? A square. 3a square b into iota. Now if we multiply it with iota b, but we will what? 3ab square iota square. Now solve this. A cube, what's the values of iota cube is? Minus iota. So I am putting here values of iota cube is minus iota, b cube plus 3a square b into iota plus 3ab square. Iota square is value negative 1. So we get a cube minus iota b cube plus 3a square b into iota minus 3ab square. What's the real part is here? This and this. A cube minus 3ab square. This one is real. And if we take iota as a common, firstly I am writing this term. We got 3a square b, then we got minus b cube. This is equal to what? X plus iota y. Now equate real part is equal to real and imaginary part with imaginary. What's the values of that we will got? X is equal to what? Is real part a cube minus 3ab square. And what's the values of imaginary part is here y, and here y is 3a square b minus b cube. So we get a and x and y values. So put it on what side? On the right hand side, because x and y are given in the right hand side. So you have to put either on the left hand side and right hand side according to the question, and you have to solve to make it out the other side. In this I am going to take right hand side. What is our right hand side is x by a plus y by b. What is x? A cube minus 3ab square divided by a. What is y? Y is what? 3a square b minus b cube divided by b. If I take common a, what I will get? Here a square minus me 3b square divided by a. If I got b common, what we will got? 3a square minus b square divided by a. Now a is cancelled out with a, b is cancelled out with b. What I will got? a square minus 3b square plus 3a square minus b square. Now combine a square and 3a square. What's the result? 4a square. Now 3b square minus b square, we got minus 4b square. If we take 4 as a common, we get a square minus b square. And this is our left hand side. I hope this question will be clear to you. It's very very easy. So these two steps we have to take. First we have to calculate the values of x and y in terms of a and b, then put it on either side, either left hand side, then make right hand side, or if you put on right hand side, then you have to make it equal to left hand side. So this type of questions probing is very very easy. If you like my video, so please don't forget to subscribe my channel Gaurav Gupta Maths Classes, and please press the button of like and do share it with your friends. We are studying or reading from the element maths, and these portions also found in your NCERT, but it has some one extra portion. So do it NCERT as well as element maths, and you can do other mathematics also, and can send the problem on my WhatsApp number, and you can email me on my email ID. So please don't forget to subscribe my channel. So we will meet to take our next video very soon. We did complete our question number 10 to question number 16. Then we do our next 4 questions in the next video. Thank you for watching my video from start to end.